Hey everyone, and welcome back. One of the coaches at Unger Academy here, and today we're going to talk about the theory and use of linear regression in trading. Before we start though, I invite you to please subscribe to our channel, click on the notification bell, and leave us a like to support our work. Thank you so much. Hi, we are the Unger Academy, and we teach traders how to make money in the markets. Our founder, Andrea Unger, had been struggling with trading for years until he developed his automated trading method, which he used to become the only four-time world trading champion. Subscribe to our channel for free tips and tricks. Well, with a view to exploring all the possibilities that systematic trading offers us, today I want to illustrate linear regression. In statistics, linear regression is used to analyze a data set and study its dependence on the mean. Here is an example of how the indicator is plotted on MultiCharts. Now we'll review some notions of statistics. Don't worry if some of the formulas are incomprehensible at first. This is more than normal. It isn't important to be able to demonstrate the theory in order to trade, but it's necessary to understand how to use the indicator. I'm sure that at the end of this video, everything will be clearer. Basically, linear regression solves the least squares equation and then finds common points where the regression line should pass. Given two theoretical values, x and y, we can calculate the regression line using the following formula, where a will be the intercept, namely the amount of y when x is equal to 0, and b is called the angular coefficient or regression coefficient, namely it will be how much y varies on average as x increases. To calculate the values of A and B, we use the method of least squares that, as we said before, minimize the sum of squares between the data points and the regression line. The data points could be, for example, the last 10 market closes, and the regression line will be the one that will identify more points with less gap. So all we'll have to do is solve this equation, which is the rewritten least squares equation. And to do this, we must calculate the first derivatives with respect to A and B and equal them to zero, and then place them inside a system that, when solved, gives us the values for A and B. Now we see that B equals N, multiplied by the covariance of X and Y divided by the deviance of X, while A equals the mean of Y minus B times the mean of X. Then the regression line, which is Y equals A plus B times X, we'll calculate the intercept called A and then multiply the value of X by the coefficient called B. We therefore see that the value of B, also called, if you remember, the regression coefficient, decides the slope of the line. As a matter of fact, if B is greater than zero, we'll have a line with a positive slope, as for example in this case. If B is less than zero, we'll have a line with a negative slope. While if B is equal to zero, we'll have a perfectly horizontal line. So in conclusion, we can say and see how the regression line identifies the common points of the variables with the smallest possible gap and has a slope in relation to the angular coefficient of the line, which can range from negative infinity to positive infinity. If you remember in the first slide, we saw the indicator plotted on MultiCharts. Here is the same linear regression indicator calculated over the last 9 periods with daily bars. But as you can see, this is a curve rather than a straight line. So why do we see a curve graphed on MultiCharts rather than a straight line? Are we doing something wrong? Well, no, we're not. We see a curve plotting the linear regression indicator because in MultiCharts, only the last value of the linear regression is graphed. In fact, by overlapping the linear regression indicator as a straight line, you'll see that only the last point, the one which will be useful for trading, is common to both indicators, this very point right here. The linear regression line updates at each bar, thus configuring different points that, if joined, will identify a curve resulting from the translation of all the lines that update from bar to bar. Now, we see in this slide an example of this mechanism, which is a bit more complex, but helpful in understanding how linear regression moves point by point. You see, if we were to go and join all these various data points generated by the regression lines in the past, there would be a sort of continuous line, which is what we see today on MultiCharts. Now, after this theoretical analysis, which for some of you might have been a bit boring, but necessary, Let's test the efficacy of this indicator on a portfolio of futures. As you can see, we're now in the power language editor of MultiCharts, the software used to design and program our strategies and indicators, functions, and so on. In this case, we've created a signal, thus a strategy that will buy and sell on the market. We've inserted, as usual, some inputs, which you can see here. The first three, price, periods, and displace, are simply the inputs that this function needs to calculate the linear regression, so it will calculate the close of the last n periods. In this case, we've left the default 9 with a displace of 0. Simply, the displace is used to translate the value of the indicator forward or backward by x bars. Now we'll leave it at 0 because we want to see the basic linear regression. And then two other inputs, stop loss and target, which will then be, we'll see it below, calculated on the ATR, which is the only variable that I created, simply by calling this function of the average true range calculated at 5 periods. As said, here we'll have the entry conditions. So if we have a close above the linear regression point, we'll basically buy at the next bar to market in continuation of trend. And vice versa, when the close will break down the level of the linear regression, then we'll sell at the next bar. As said, the stop loss is calculated on the ATR because we're going to test this type of strategy on a very varied futures portfolio, which includes very different markets. Consequently, in order to standardize in some way, the results will use a stop loss and a profit target based on the ATR. So now let's move on to the MultiCharts Portfolio Trader. And as you can see, we have already uploaded a handful of futures of different types. And this is why we'll use a uniform time zone on all of them, thus the local time zone. Otherwise, you wouldn't be able to mix instruments with different time zones using the software, the MultiCharts Portfolio Trader. Let's now apply our strategy. I've already optimized the main values, such as the periods, which have been set to 40. We're on daily bars, and thus there are 40 trading days. Displace is 0, and the stop loss and take profit were set at the same level at twice the 5-day daily ATR. Let's now see how the strategy works on this portfolio of futures. Here are the results. Obviously, this is a strategy that we've already optimized, because as previously said, we've chosen the best values. But we definitely see that on this portfolio, the first results of the strategy are certainly interesting. Let's go look at the resulting average trade. We're at about $100 in 7,879 trades. The short side loses while the long side gains. And this may be because in this portfolio, we included both equity indexes and bonds, which, as you know, have a strong bullish bias. Obviously, this is something that doesn't really help with trading the short side. However, though, overall, I think we can be satisfied. Linear regression could be one of the many indicators that we can use to build our strategies. We could also modify it by adding some bands, calculated as the standard deviation of the linear regression, and enter on a cleaner breakout, as if they were Bollinger bands. So you see, really, the possibilities are clearly endless. And in our opinion, this is surely a good starting point. So why not give it a try? Well, we really hope that you have found this video helpful. Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. Also, don't forget to leave us a like. If, of course, you liked the video, subscribe to our channel and click on the notification bell to stay updated on the release of all our new videos coming soon. Below, you'll also find a link to a completely free webinar by the four-time world trading champion, Andrea Unger, who will explain step-by-step how to become successful in the financial markets. Thank you so much for watching this video, and we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.